This was a pretty good interview, but rather long and lengthy, so I just skipped it and posted highlights. I hope you enjoy it.
Because the New York Times has reporting that the president okayed the statement.
That's, well, they're incorrect.
The New York Times is wrong.
Yeah, I know. Is that shocking that sometimes I make a mistake? What statute is, a meeting takes place between Donald Trump Jr. and this lawyer. What criminal statute, what civil statute has been violated? None.
Honestly, if you've been watching the show, which you say you have, you've never heard me say that this is clear indication of a crime.
Your network has aired interviews with Natalia saying it did not happen. You put it on the air.
I understand. There's no question that we've done it, and we'll probably do it a lot today. That doesn't mean it's true. I have a lot of people come on my show and say things, counselor, and they ain't true.
What is the legal standard? What you're saying, it's obviously inappropriate.
Obviously.
Okay. What is the legal standard where inappropriate, as you put it, obviously inappropriate? What legal standard is that?
Appropriate. You want to talk about the law? Please.
Well, you know political campaigns well. You come from a long heritage of families in political campaigns. You know what happens in the heat of campaign. There's a lot of meetings. The Ukrainian government was giving information to the DNC and to Hillary Clinton's people on who? Donald Trump. So we're acting as this doesn't happen. Like,
so
happens
let's look
the
at it.
But
it. Let's look at it very quickly. Yeah. Ukraine is not Russia. Okay? You can get Oppo research from whoever you want. But if you solicit information from a foreign government, let alone a hostile one, you could be in trouble with the FEC. But again, I don't want to talk about legality. No. That's not my place. It's got to be about doing what's right.
But Chris, you just said if the Ukrainians did it, it's fine. If the Russians do it, it's not.
I did not ever say that, and I will send you the transcript.
That's completely different.
No, but I never said it. What I said was, Ukraine is not Russia.
Chris, is it okay, in your view, for the Ukrainians to give a dossier information they got governmentally on then-President Trump to the DNC and the Hillary Clinton campaign? Is that okay with you?
Look, one,
is that okay?
Not a duck, but one, let's be honest.
Is it okay?
One, not my call, special counsel. Two, is it illegal? No, because I think solicitation is what triggers your election law standards.
The meeting that Donald Trump Jr. took was a violation of the law.
I don't know. It's not for me to say. The standard is tight. Treason is a very tight statute.
Oh, you know
the FEC laws are about solicitation.
But Chris, you're a smart guy. You know this isn't treason.
Why does he insist on calling it a witch hunt despite what he just saw in his son's own emails?
Well, look at the basis upon which this investigation was triggered. James Comey leaks internal memos that he took of conversations with the President of the United States. He takes them in his meeting with the President. He puts them in his government computer, sticks them in his government desk, and creates a memo that he leaks when he gets fired to a friend of his to go to the press for the sole purpose, he said, under oath, of obtaining a special counsel, which is then appointed.
Right.
There's a special counsel appointed, and think about this, Chris, for a moment.
Yes,
he gets a special counsel is appointed based on what? Illegally leaked evidence. I don't think that's okay, and if you were a lawyer in my situation...
I don't know that it's illegally leaked evidence, and it was appointed by Trump's
FBI
guy at the DOJ, Rosenstein.
Rosenstein didn't leak the information.
No. Rosenstein is responsible for the special counsel. That is someone that the president leaned very heavily on, said he was of the highest regard.
What is the basis of the special counsel being appointed? You and I know it. The whole world knows it because James Comey testified under oath. He did the release and leaked the information that was to get the special counsel.
Mr. Rosenstein, but I would suggest that's only part of what went into his decision. He certainly didn't say he did it because Comey wanted it.
Chris, you think
that this was a great move?
Yeah. Chris, do you think that it's okay for James Comey, the FBI director, to take the notes of his conversation with the president and then release